Thank you. Mr. Black. Been a while. Last time we saw each other would have been... Let me see.
When I stole the corner gun.
Ah, yes. When you stole my corner gun for Robert Ramsey. Really, I should just have killed you on the spot. I'd feel so much better about everything.
Then why don't you?
You're so exquisite. So flawless in the way you ruined me and my company. I wanted to even the playing field a little. Do something similar to Ramsey. And I racked my brains and I just couldn't think of who would be the best man for the job. Then it occurred to me.
Me? I'm Ramsey's head of security. Why would I work for you?
Every man has his price, sir. Especially you.
I'm paid well.
Yes, but not as well as you'd like to be. Not as well as you could be.
It's not about the money.
That old chestnut. Okay, fine. Then how about this? According to my sources, Ramsey has a surprisingly accurate record of your criminal history, far more so than the police. Seems to me he's got you over a bit of a barrel. Work for him or go to prison. The way I see it, Mr. Black. You're his bitch.
You sound jealous.
I envy no man, Black. If someone has something I want, I take it for myself. So here's my offer, and I'll only make it once. You work for me, not Ramsey. I devise a plan to get Ramsey's Pandora device, and you carry it out. You name your price within reason, and if you're successful, I'll forget about the whole corner gun fiasco, and we'll both be on our merry way. How does that sound?
If I refuse?
You're alive because you're useful, Black. Don't get any ideas.
No.
Excuse me.
I said no.
I'm not sure I've been clear enough here, Black.
Oh, you've been clear. But I refuse your offer, Howard. I'll not work for you. I'll never work for you. I'll not carry on this little plan of yours. I don't agree to any of it. I refuse.